Try. No matter what they throw my way, no, I'm still gonna fight. Even when it all went left, still did you right. I know that you went in the wrong, but I'm still gonna ride for you. How you leave me deep in the dark when I gave you light. That you put the blame on me, threw away my pride. It could be a million miles, but I'm still gonna slide for you. You already know I need you by my side.
Won't you stand?
Won't you stand? Won't you stand by me? Time with you. Promise that you'll stand by me. Oh, won't you stay? Won't you stay by me? I just need a little more time. I just need a little more time with you. Things I ain't want to. I done went and lost my soul. I was losing sight, couldn't see you through. Walk around with both eyes closed. If I say I'm standing for you, you know that I'm standing ten toes. Even when they told me not to, I kept my brothers close. You already know I'm a type to push when we get broke down. Now every time I look for you, it's like you're not around. Still I don't see no loss. I did everything from the heart. If you lean on me, I promise that you won't fall. Won't you stand? Won't you stand by me? I just need a little more time. I just need a little more time with you.
Let the church say amen. Amen. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Somebody all over the building. I know we're at a funeral. This is the day that the Lord hath made. And I will rejoice and be glad in it. We just want to say to the family, we extend our sympathy towards you and the family. We'll try not to be here long. Thank the ministers and those who are on the program for supporting this family, those who came by, maybe gave a flower, gave a dollar or something. We want to tell you thank you.
Amen. Amen.
Are y'all going to help me preach? Okay. If y'all don't say amen, we'll be here all day. Okay. At this time, we have a hymn of comfort. You are my strength, William Murphy. Then after that, Old Testament reading by Minister James Moore, the New Testament by Tamla. I said that last night. Yeah, y'all got it right. I can't get it.
Fullness of your grace. Come on, church.
In the fullness of your grace.
In the power of your name.
In the power
place tonight. Thank you for being so gracious. Thank you for being so kind. Thank you for staying. Thank you for loving me. Flaws and all.
Truly, I want to say that our hearts are heavy and hurting. But to the family, I want to say there is no sorrow that God doesn't feel, and there is no pain that he doesn't heal. Only thing we got to do is keep looking to the Lord, keep looking to the hills which come by our help, and we know all our help coming from him. And as we look to the Lord, let's lean and depend on each other. This is a time where we need to wrap our arms around each other and just show each other that we love each other, because we need each other in a time like this. I'll be reading Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me into the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley, shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod, thy staff, thou comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And that's where we'll find our peace, is in the house of the Lord.
Sorry. First, I want to say to Barbara, my sister, I was in your position about a year ago, and I know you struggle, and I know it's hard, but I just want to encourage you to hold on to God's unchanging hand like never before, because despite what we see, God knows what's best for all of us, including our babies that he took. My little lumper, y'all called him Lump. He was, to me, he was Lumper. That's how I see him. And you know what? He will be missed, but I'm going to be coming to you from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 through 14. And it says, but we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Let us pray. Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. Eternal wise, our kind Heavenly Father, we come for the comfort of the family. God, you left us a legacy here. Oh God, we ask you to look on right now in the name of Jesus. Though they may grieve and they may cry, but you are God of comfort. Oh, in times like this, God. Now, God, I pray even now for the man of God. Gonna stand on the watch for all of the time. And declare, so many people have came far and near, God. Oh, God, we're living in time now that we all going to have to see you one more time. Oh, God, we pray right now that you look on them right now, God. Comfort them in the time of the sorrow. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. knows my name. He knows my name. He knows my name. He knows my name. Oh, how he walks with me. Oh, how he talks with me. And oh, how he tells me I am his own. You know my name. You know my name. Yeah. You know my name. You know my name. And oh, how he comforts me. And oh, how he counsels me. It still amazes me. I am his friend. So now I pour out. Here in your presence, you know my name, yeah, yeah, yeah. You know my name, yeah. You. Your power is within me. No giant can defeat me, 'cause you hold my hand. No fire, yeah. No battle can turn me. No mountain can stop me, yeah, yeah, yeah. You hold my hand, yeah, 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 yeah. I'm walking. You hold
At this time, we will have tribute from the slideshow at this time. At this time, reflection with David Wells and Chris Spears at this time. David Cole, Wells, would you come? And then Chris Spears.
To the family, allowing me to come by after a very short time had passed with David's passing. Thank you. And thank you for allowing me to speak just a little bit about not just a former student, but a friend. P4L, Panther for Life. That's who we are at High Brighton. I saw a lot of David during the 4 years at High Brighton, of course. I had him for 4 years. We know about the tackles for loss, the quarterback sacks. We know about all of that. But the one memory I have of him was, ironically, during the basketball season, and I'm sure Coach Keller can relate. It was early in the season, and he had a torn ACL. Do you think he was sitting on the bench in street clothes? Nope. Up and down that court, up and down that court, up and down that court, up and down that court. Played every minute of a lot of games with a torn ACL. The only time he ever limped was when he, at halftime, as they were coming into the locker room, I saw a little bit of a limp. I remember after a game, I went over to him and I said, "How do you do it?" He said, "Man, this is how, Brighton." He said, "We got to win. We got to win." And he laughed, of course. He just laughed. I'm not going to take a lot of time here, but all of you, all of my students who are with me at High Brighton, would you do me a favor and stand? Keep standing. Keep standing, please. Here's what I want to share with you, and I shared this with a family. David would usually find me first, whether it was at Walmart pumping gas, or we just stopped side by side in our cars. We never ended a conversation without saying three words to each other. I love you. Amen. And I want all of you to know that if I never get a chance to say this again, you need to know that I respect you, I thank you, but from David Patterson and David Caldwell, we love you. We will always love you. And to David, when I go home tonight and lay my head on the pillow, don't worry, I've got three words for you, and I know this. You'll say them right back to me. I love you.
Amen. And we love you too. Amen. Amen.
Okay, this is not going to be easy at all, guys. I'm not a speaker. Thank the family for asking me to speak. Guys, you know how I feel about you. I like to say I stand up here and understand this, but I don't. Sunday, I was coming back from Ohio, and I seen the worst thing I could ever see, and it was the passing of, I can't call him David, I call him Lump. He was his mama's lump of love, that's what he always told us. And so we called him up. But I went through an array of emotions, just like you feel, from anger to crying to not understanding, and I still don't to this day. But I can tell you from him being in our house growing up a lot, him and Jody friends, a lot of stories. I can sit here and talk about Lump days and days and days on end. I mean, from the boys skinny dipping and streaking through the house. They was seven or eight of them. There's a few here I could point out. To Lump loving getting in the candy or the snack drawer. He loved that snack drawer. 1 o'clock at night, you hear rattling going on. He's getting stuff out of the snack board. Just on and on stories. We took him to see the, what was that place? Took him to see the animals that time. Lazy Five. That was a new experience for him when ostrich tried to get him. He threw this bucket down to ostrich and stuff. So a lot of stories. And like Mr. Caldwell said, there's a lot of fun times, but I want to tell you a small story about Lump. We was at a basketball game playing. He come to the court. He wasn't hitting nothing that day. He said, Coach, take me out. And I said, why? He said, I'm upset. He said, I can't hit anything. I said, so you want to quit on me because you're not hitting anything? He said, no, just take me out. But I didn't take him out. After the game, he come to me and he said, Coach, he said, thank you. And I said, for what? He said, for not taking me out. He said, thank you for believing in me. And what I should have told him back, and I didn't, was thank you for believing in me. Lump was more than a ball player, no matter what sport. He broke boundaries. They was kids from all three high schools, kids from Freedom that played with us. It was more than just a ball club. It was a family. You know, a lot of those guys are here. But
it's all right.
What he taught us was how to love. He didn't see any race. He didn't see any money issues, no financial differences. He didn't see anything. He just saw people. And that's what I'm gonna miss so much about Lump, because I seen him at the gas station a lot too. I'd have my back to him. He'd holler at me coming out the door with a big hug. Show me pictures. Man, I love that kid. My family loved that kid. So in closing, I know it's sad, man. I thought about this kid every minute since Sunday. But in closing, guys, and I had this big speech. It's gone. I don't know where it went, but let's treat each other the way Lump treated us. You know, there's no race differences. There's nothing. We all need to love each other.
Amen.
To the family again, thank you for letting me stand up here. It's been an honor. And thank you so much for sharing a small part of Lump's life with us. And like I said, night or day, I'm there. You need anything. Lump's babies need anything. Night or day, call us. Okay. And we love you.
I think we have something special. At this time, we'll do it right now. Will y'all please come? It's something special.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Coach Mackey. I'm the head football coach at High Brighton. This is Coach Lewis. Coach Lewis was the head coach. While Dave was there, Lump was there. I was defense coordinator during that time. To the family, High Brighton football was such a huge, huge part of Lump's life. And I remember when I first came there, it was his sophomore year. And wanted to change the entire defense and everything, and Lump was a crucial part of that. And I said, Coach, whatever you got or whatever you need, I've got you. And not only him, but many others in this room carried that same mantra. And he was truly one of a kind. He's truly one of a kind. He's smiling in heaven, I know that for sure. I can't know. I wait for the day that he can tell me, Coach, I got you again. We want to present two of Lump's jerseys to the family on behalf of High Brighton Football and the coaches that had a part in his life.
Come on, we can do better than that. Come on, we can do better than that. Come on, somebody. I'd like to thank the High Brighton High School for what they've just done. I'm also was a Panther. All of my brothers, all of us went to High Brighton High School. Thank y'all for what y'all just done. This time you have your obituary. Let's read it silent at this time. Amen. This time we have a selection by Sister Toni Carlton.
Are you going to do the tribute?
That was the tribute.
You're not going to get them people 2 minutes.
See? Did they want me to let somebody else get up there? Did they want me to do it?
No, I had a poem that I took out of Pye's book that I wanted.
Okay, we'll make it happen. We'll make it happen. I'll let you go. Okay.
That'll work. Lift up mine eyes to the hills. From whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. The Lord which made heaven and earth. He said he would not suffer thy foot to be moved. The Lord which keepeth me, he will not slumber nor sleep. Oh, thou Lord is thy keeper, The Lord is the shade. Hallelujah. Upon thy right hand. Upon thy right hand. Oh, the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. He shall preserve my soul, even forevermore. My help, my help, my help, all of my help, it cometh from the Lord, oh the Lord, oh the Lord.
What do you want to do? Something else.
I will lift up mine eyes unto the Lord which made heaven and earth, he said,
it must be on the big
he would not suffer thy foot to be moved. The Lord which keepeth thee, he will not slumber nor sleep for.
On the right hand,
on the right hand, oh,
Come on.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. Okay. Amen. This time we oversight just a little bit. We're going to addiction reflection. Before we open it up, we're going to have Reverend Moore to come and do a poem. And then we're going to open up for 2 minutes. 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Got it.
As I was going through, I like to kind of reflect on some of our nephew's poems. Jacob Pieface Patterson. He wrote this poem of books, and I keep it, and I try to read one every now and then. And as I woke up this morning, one caught my attention, and as I looked at the words in it, it fit what Lump would say to Barbara. And David, I know he loved you, but this poem here is simply called Barbara Patterson. And it reads as, B is for the beauty you possess on the inside as well as the outside. A is for the great assess you are to me and all the boys. R is for the righteous you show in all you do. B is for your ability to bear with me throughout eternity. R is for your great ability to have a relationship with God and me. A is for ain't nobody going to ever take your place. P is for the patience you display when things get hard. A is for the angelic forces that gives you strength. T is for overcoming unwanted trials and tribulations. T is for the treasure you are to me and the rest of the world. E is for everlasting love that you and I share. R is for simply being real. S is for the salvation given freely by God. O is for only you can make me happy. N is for nested in your love and never having to worry. That's Barbara Patterson. And I can just see him and Lump there with that little silly grin he do. I can see that.
Okay, who want to be first? You got 2 minutes to say something. Now, we can't give everybody in this room 2 minutes. You can come on. Y'all both come on.
Now. Well, all I can say, first and foremost, I truly appreciate all the mornings, the days, and the nights I got to spend with my brother Dave, Sister Ba, Quish, and later on down the line, Sister Liz are there, and Brother Woody as well. You know, I got to know Lump Jr. whenever he was a small guy, you know, because me and Dave would be riding around, you know. We'd be talking, and he'd listen to what we're saying, and he always had a smile on his face, you know. And I come and got to know him, you know. And I got to know him as he grew older. I was watching him as he growing. He was showing me all the qualities he possessed. And, you know, he was a great young man. He was becoming a great young man. Not only did I see him as a friend, but I see him as a part of my family also. And saying that, I just say, David and the family, they always remember, like I said earlier, that God always knows the hurt we feel. So always remember that he's always with you and he's always by your side. Thank you.
Oh man, oh man, oh man. Me and Lump go way back, all the way from Drexel to college. Nah, hey, I was taller than Lump at one point in time, I promise. He'll tell everybody that. But that's this one time, I promise that stick with me. We was at Lewisburg. We all playing for pickup football. They picking on me. No, Lump started it. He started picking on me because I was limping. Then he was like, what, you want me to get out there and make you start doing what I do? I was like, bro, leave me alone. So then the people from Lewisburg started picking on me. Then all I know, I looked at him, I said, Lump, you done started something that you done messed up now. So we kept going and going. They threw the ball my way. He said, you ain't going to do nothing. Turned around, I picked it the next play, and Lump started jumping up and down, like he was my biggest fan. Then he just started screaming, he's the reason why I respect short people. He's the only one I ain't caught on. I'm the only one. To this day, I still will never give his rematch. I ran from him.
Anyone else? Yes.
First, let me say my condolences to the family. One of the best kids I've ever been around in my entire life. The group of kids that I coached with Lump, they were so respectful and they were so hardworking and they were all a team and they played together and Lump was a part of that all the time, always smiling, but he always busted his tail. No matter what you ask him to do, if he said he's going to do it, he's going to do it. He spent a lot of time at my house. He always wanted some more wings. You know, coach, when are we going to do some more wings? We're going to do some more wings. But that smile would just melt you. And I learned probably more from him than he'll ever learn from me. And it took us a while. And I was with him for, like I said, about 6 or 7 years coaching. But I know that he is in a better place. I know that it was his time. And we can't question that. Because the person he was, God said, come on, come on. I know we're going to miss him. I miss him dearly. I told somebody today, I said, you know, I could walk in my house and Lumpty Dump, as I called him a lot, Lump could be laying on my sofa, eating my food, doing whatever he wanted to do, and I'd walk by and be like, you need something else? I had that much trust in that kid. The family did such a great job. You raised a great son. You raised a great boy. And you guys should be proud of yourselves because I know he was proud of y'all. I know that for a fact. Love y'all. Always will. If you need me, let me know.
Thank you, Coach.
This is real hard for me to do this, y'all. I'm sorry. But I just want to say thank you to the whole Patterson family. Y'all have been in my life, my whole life. The second family that I needed. And he would kill me if I sat there and didn't say nothing. He said, Chess, you always got something to say. I don't care. I ain't telling you nothing because you always got something to say. But that was my brother that I never had. And y'all were the family that I needed. And I thank y'all for raising him to be the person that he was. And just to know that Lump would always make sure anybody got safe home. He would make sure no matter what. No matter what. I remember I was at the beach. I was with somebody I shouldn't have been with. But Lump was there. I came and went on in them. And he was like, Chesney, well, you going to make it home? And I was like, yeah, I'm going to make it home. But I'm going to sit right here with y'all and hang out with y'all and everything. And my ride was long gone. We couldn't even hear from her nothing. And Lump told everybody, she's with me. No matter what, she's getting home with me. I don't care what's happening, she's getting home with me. And I thank him for that to this day. And I just thank y'all and I love y'all. And I didn't want to accept this. I did not want to accept it. I didn't. And I'm so sorry. And he loved everybody. Lump made everybody feel loved. No matter who you was, he made everybody feel loved. And I want to make y'all feel loved and everybody just stick together because that's what he would want. He would want all of us to be together no matter what. He would want all of us to be together. And I love y'all.
I'd like to say to David, me and Lump go back a long ways. When he was a little boy, I said, Lump, now if you do good in school, and you every time you make a touchdown, I'm going to give you $5. Well, David would come by and say, he done it again. He got to doing it so much, them $5 got to come into a regular. I said, Lump, you're going to have to slow down. That's about all I, and I'm still $20 with you, Lump, but that's it. Amen.
I just want to say I love y'all family. And I'm up here today because I don't even know what to say, but I know a Lump of you up here for me. He probably won't be up here the way I am today. He'd probably be joking, laughing, smiling. His favorite thing to say to me was, Brad, you can't catch a cold butt naked and boom. We had plenty of times, plenty of fun, a lot of sayings and things we used to say. And I'm up here another reason, because I know my brothers, they couldn't be up here to do what I'm doing right now. It's hard for me. There's plenty of times, you know, I was feeling some type of way or anything, you know, something Lump knew. Plenty of times. I just, you know, felt like I just want to lay out of practice or, you know, stay home. Lump called me and say, hey, man, I'm coming to get you. That was my brother. We all brothers in here. And it's always going to be that way. And I just want to thank y'all for just letting me come up here just to say something. I didn't know what I was going to say. But that was my brother.
I honestly don't know what I'm gonna say. But this man right here, this man taught me things I never knew. I never knew I could do. I was at a dark place in my life when I started my junior year. But this family right here, this family and this boy, save me. I didn't want to be here anymore. The pain I feel today, I don't now. But I know you tell me to shut up and stop crying. I'd always call him and I'd go, Lump, I'm pissed off. And he'd go, it's better to be pissed off than pissed on. And I get mad. And I get mad and I tell him, stop talking to me. He said, I'm only telling you the truth, man. Life's too short to be hating somebody or being mad at somebody. And I know all y'all in here might not know who I am. And if y'all don't, y'all knew I was with him every day. Every day. These last couple months, we ain't been close as we used to be. They have been the hardest months of my life. And I don't know where I'm going to go from here. But his plan for me was to go to school. So I will be going to school. That's the only choice I have because he told me to. Miss David, Mr. David, I'm sorry. Miss Barbara, thank y'all. Y'all gave me the greatest human being I could ever meet in my life. And I'm so sorry he's gone. I wish I could go back and rewind and be in his spot. I love y'all so much.
I don't want to be before you long. I just got a few words there to say to the Patterson family. This is tough. This is real tough. The Patterson family has been under attack. The attack comes because of the anointing that's on our lives. We are living examples to everybody in the community and everybody we come in contact. This young man was a living testimony. Every time I seen him, it was like the last day I could see him. And it was so encouraging every time he talked to me. And like me and David talked, all he wanted to do was go fishing with me. He didn't ever get that chance, but young man, yeah, rest easy. Rest easy.
Try to hold it together up here. I met Lump when I was super duper young, and we played a whole lot of different sports together. But we were never just friends from the day one. We always told each other that we were brothers. And I called his mom and dad, as I still do, and he called my parents the same. And I just felt like I had a second family as soon as I met him. He was one of the most genuine-hearted people that I could ever be around. His name truly fit a lump of love because that's what he was to everybody came in contact with. I have so many friends that I wouldn't have and that I wouldn't have met just because of how much of love Lump had for people. One of the last times I got to talk to Lump, he told me that no matter what, he was going to have my back because that's what brothers do. And I told him that I was going to have his back, not only him, but his family and his kids, that I would always have their back. And I'll continue to carry on his legacy with me regardless of wherever I go because that was my brother. I told him every single day that I laid my life down for him and that I love him. And he knew that. And I knew he would do the same for me. Thank you.
thought it was going to be really hard. But I know God's got me. And one of Lump's favorite scripture was, I can do all faith through Christ that strengthens me. And I told Pastor the other day, I said, I was going to do the eulogy. And I told him, I said, Pastor, if I can't make it through the eulogy, will you take my place? He said, man, you crazy. It'll be an honor. I can't say much, but I am going to say, if you really think about life, and what life has come out to be, you would think twice. You would think twice. The reason I said that, all these songs that were sung today was about strength. And every time somebody prays for somebody, it's about strength. And I was thinking at home, I said, when I wanted to lift weights, I had to go to the weight pal to get my strength. And now each and every one of y'all in here right now got a lot of strength, but it's not in the Lord. As when he first died, I said, I got to be strong for my family. And the only thing I could keep on saying was, Lord, you gave it to me 25 years. And I said, Lord, I asked before I started talking, I said, why? Why? And he let me know that he was ready. And that he was going to come back for the other people that gets ready for him. All right. I just pray that his death don't go in vain. But to finish going on what I was saying, I was sitting there thinking, Lord, you must strength. Because he said, well, he was everything by strength. And back in the days, I was a heavy drinker. And everything I'd done was because I was a drinker. Back then, that was my strength. As I used that for my strength, it would always go away sooner or later. And then I was back at the bottom of the barrel again. Now, I was at home. I told my brother, I said, I need some wine coolers because that's my strength. I drank a few. But when it went away, the same situation come back. And there's some of us out here, their strength is pills. Some people out there, their strength is alcohol like mine was. Some people's strength is their husband and their wife. Some people's strength is their family. But I'm here to tell you, he said, all if you trust in him. If you get the strength of the Lord, he would take away the other strength and show you what power really is. Yes. And the reason I love strength, that scripture even more too, because I know he's my strength now. Yeah. And I know I can make it.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
And each and every one of you that don't have strength first in your life, you need to get him. And I'm not trying to push him on nobody or nothing like that. It's all up to you. The word of God said, work out your own soul salvation. Each and every one of us got our own way of working it out. But if you got God in your life, it would be a lot easier.
I want to give honor to God. Okay, come on.
Amen.
I'll meet you with her.
Thank you, Mom.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, church.
Bless the Lord.
God is good.
God is good.
All the time, God is good.
Amen.
I just wanted to tell you, everybody looks around and they want to know why was it lump of love. Because the doctor said I couldn't have any children. But God said I can. And I did. And I thank and praise God every single day for lump. That was my lump of love. And when I would take him every single morning, he was hard to get to sleep. I would take and roll him, and kiss him all the way around the face. He went to sleep. And I said, this is my lump of love. And this young man right here, he said, Mama, it's okay. People do me wrong, Mama. It's okay. Because I'd be ready to fight. I'm telling you. I'd be ready to fight. And he'd say, it's okay, Mama. It's okay. Because guess what? In the end, guess who's going to get the victory? In the end, guess what it's all about? It's all about God. And just like my husband said, please don't let this day go in vain. Don't let it go in vain. Because just like I said, I said that truck took my son's life. God said, no, no. He said he didn't have the power to give it. And he didn't have the power to take it away. I know who God is. And I shall praise him for the rest of my days. May not be easy, but I'm going to praise God because he is Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Shalom. Hallelujah. Nobody but God. Nobody but God that can keep me. Thank you, church.
Amen. Okay. Well, that makes my preaching easy now. I think we all on the same page. I found this. I'm going to read it to everybody. If you are rejected, accept it. If you are unloved, let it go. If they choose someone or something over you, move on. Not everyone you love will stay. Not everyone you trust will be loyal. I do not care about losing people. I do not wonder who do not want who do not want to be in my life anymore. If I lose some people who meant the world to me, if I still doing just fine, always speak how you feel and never be sorry for being real. You may not be able to control every situation and outcome, but you can control your attitude. Amen. I got one amen.
Amen. Amen.
And how you deal with it, do good. It will come back to you unexpected ways. Be happy with what you have while working for what you want. Remember that some things have to end for better things to begin.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen?
It's preaching time, and I promise you I won't be before you long. We're just going to do what thus said the Lord and get out of the way. I know this family's tired. I know they've been going through some things, and I thank Minister David for his friendship. We grew up together since we was kids, over on the west side.
West side.
And I thank God for that. I want to use for the subject this evening, I want to talk about the Good Shepherd. Psalm 23, 1 through 6. And it reads like this. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. David started by saying, the Lord is my shepherd. To understand what David is trying to say, you got to look back into the scripture. Y'all pray for me. Listen, what happened? David said, the Lord is my shepherd. He said these words in 2 Samuel chapter 12 in verse 19. But when David saw that his servant whispered, David perceived that the child was dead. Therefore said unto his servant, is the child dead? They said, he is dead. But I want you to understand how David could say, the Lord is my shepherd. Listen what he said. Then David rose from the earth and washed and anointed himself, changed his appearance, and came into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Y'all didn't hear nothing I just said. David just lost his child with Bathsheba, and everybody's upset, and David was upset, wanted the child not to die. But he said he came to the house of the Lord and worshiped. Wait a minute, Reverend Wilfong, are you sure? Well, that's what the scriptures say. How can you go in the house of the Lord? I just lost a child. How can I go in there and give God the praise? That's why David can say, the Lord is my shepherd. Y'all stay with me now. Don't go nowhere. So they went in there and worshiped. Then he came here to his own house and required they set bread before him, and it did eat. Listen now. Then said his servant to him, what thing is this that thou hast done? Thou did fast, and you wept for the child while he was alive. But when the child was dead, thou did rise and eat bread. And he said, while the child was yet alive, I fasted and wept. For I can say, who can tell whether God will be gracious unto me that the child may live? But now he is dead. Wherefore should I fast? Can I bring him back again? Or should I go to him? But he shall not return to me. In other words, if you're not right with God, you won't see brother no more. That's what he was saying. So we, in other words, we get to learn to get our house in order. Preach, Reverend Wilfong, and I will. We got to get our house in order. So you got to understand how David could say, the Lord is my shepherd. On another occasion, an accident happened again to David. His son Absalom was killed. Now you got to understand, this man, David, loved his son Absalom. His son rebelled against him, tried to take over his kingdom, wanted to kill his own daddy. But David still loved him. And watch this now. And it says in 18 verse 14, it says this. Then Joab, I may not tarry this with thee. And he took three darts in his hand and thrust them into the heart of Absalom, while he was yet alive in the midst of the oak. And then the 10 young men that bear Joab army compassed about and smote Absalom and slew him. Even through all of this, David still loved his son. And I like what they said about love. We got to learn to love each other.
Amen.
It will be great on Sunday tomorrow to see the church like this.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all hear nothing I said? It will be great to come to church tomorrow to see all of us in a setting like this. Reverend Wilfong, what you're trying to say? Well, thank you for asking. Every Sunday, don't get me wrong or don't get it twisted. Caucasian brothers and sisters, they go to their own church. Come on, talk back to me, somebody. And the black folks go to their own church. Why come we can't worship together? We play basketball together. We play football together. We play soccer together. We play softball together. We play baseball together. But when it comes to the house of God, we do like that. I know it's tight. The good shepherd. I like that, man. I know sometimes we do ask God why. But David did not ask God why. He rise up and went into the house of the Lord and began to worship.
Amen.
He began to give God the praise. Because God has been good to all of us.
Amen.
God's been good to everybody on this side.
Amen.
I don't care if you're lost or saved. God's been good to you.
Amen.
You're doing good, Reverend Wilfong. Thank you. Brothers and sisters, yes, the Bible, I'm a Bible man, the Bible says in John 10:10, listen to me, the thief come not but to steal and to kill and destroy. But Jesus said, I come that you might have life and that you have it more abundantly. The parents got up here and said what they had to say. It consists of what I'm going to say to you today. You got to make up in your mind what you're going to do with your life. We all have made mistakes. We all have made wrong decisions. We done some stupid stuff. Come on, talk back to me, somebody. When I was a teenager, I made some mistakes. Don't think because you're young and I'm a little older than you that I ain't been there. I've been where you've been before.
Amen.
I was an alcoholic for 18 years.
Uh-huh.
I tried to commit suicide 3 times.
Yeah.
I'm here to tell you that life is better with Jesus.
Yeah.
And he said in that same chapter, that, matter of fact, in case some of you don't know it, the devil don't like you. You can't, no, now let me say it over here. The devil don't like you. He wants you to mess up your life. He wants you to do crazy stuff, destroy your life. Because everybody in here, God got a purpose.
Amen.
Reverend Wilfong, you mean to tell me God got a purpose for me? Well, I'm going to give you scripture. And I think it's Jeremiah 29, verse 11. He's got a purpose for you. I'm not going to tell you what it says. That's your assignment. I want you to go back and read that, young people. God got a purpose for you. He had a purpose for me, but I took the wrong route. I went down the wrong track. I tried to do it my way and do it what I wanted to do it. But I'm here to tell you, the devil didn't like me. He tried to kill me 3 times. I OD'd with pills. You said something about pills. They got me to the hospital just in time to save my life. And then I tried to take a rope and hang myself. I'm a teenager. I wanted to die. I didn't want to live no more. I didn't want to be a teenager. So much pressure on my life. Then I take a 45, put it right here to blow my brains out. Teenager, young boy. What did I get? What happened?
Bless
him, God. I give up on life. But I'm here to tell you, I understand what David's saying. The Lord is my shepherd. And I shall not want. In the book of John 10 and verse 11, listen what he said. He said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giving his life for his sheep. I don't know how you feel today on what you're going through, if you're saved or not saved. But I'm here to tell you, brothers and sisters, Jesus loves you. And there's nothing you can do about it. But it's up to us as individual to make a choice to do right or do wrong. As a teenager, I've done the wrong things. I shouldn't be standing here today. I should be dead right now myself. But God's grace and mercy kept me, guide me. Who? Now listen, I'm talking about the good shepherd David talking about. Who would imagine that God can take nothing and make something out of it? How can God take a drug addict, alcoholic, man that tried to commit suicide, the man that's been in and out of prison, the man that's been out of a mental institution? How can God use somebody like that? When I was at High Brighton High School, me and my brother Howard Tate, he played football for them. And I decided I wanted to play football. I wanted to play basketball. I thought I was good. I thought I was going to be another Jerry Rice. And I could catch the ball just like that. Oh, boom, in my hand. But I made a decision. I wrote a smoke pop. Come on. I'd rather get high. Hang out with my buddy. Let me rephrase that. So-called buddies. If you're sitting up in here and you hear and you're under my voice and you have that smoking pot, you're making the wrong decision. Oh, a little pot ain't gonna hurt. I beg the difference. I thought maybe smoke a little pot. Now I started drinking. Started getting that hard drugs. The liquor. Oh, y'all hearing what I'm saying? I'm young like y'all was. Thought I knew it all. Until I met the good shepherd. I don't know where you stand today and how you doing in life, but you got an opportunity to change direction. If you're going down the wrong path, you can change direction. Thank you. Y'all stay with me now. And I thought about this. Thought about King David. He's a little boy, 12 years old, and the Bible said he was out in the field attending the sheep. That's what the Bible said. He was in the field tending the sheep while his other brother, they were talking about fighting this big old giant, but he was in the field. And he reminded King Saul at the time, I'm going to take this giant down. The Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. He said, I'd beat this giant down. Little 12-year-old boy.
Go ahead, Richard.
Little scunny little fella.
Yep.
I'm going to whoop this giant. King Saul looked at him and said, ain't no way.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Ain't no way you can beat this giant. Even the own King Saul wouldn't fight him. But David reminded King Saul of some things that God done for him. He said, let me tell you a story. You see, one day I was out in the field and I was tending the sheep and there was a lion came out of the woods. He said, I grabbed him by the mouth and broke his jaw. He said, on another occasion, there was a bear came to take one out of the sheep and I pulled the sheep out of his mouth and slayed the bear. I come by to tell somebody, if you got some... He said, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. He said, I'm going to whoop this giant. He defied the living God. The Lord is my shepherd. See, he knew he could beat this giant. I'm scared. I can't do it. The Bible says, I'm paraphrasing, he went to the river, got down the river, and he got five smooth stones. Five of them. There's a reason why he got five, and I'll tell you. The good shepherd, David knows what he's talking about. Because the Bible says in Psalm 121, verse 1 and 2, he said, my eyes will look toward the hill from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. So you got to follow me down the road. Came up against that giant. Had a little rock. He got that thing swung. He ran toward that giant. Hit him right between the eyes and the giant. He killed the giant. Everybody else was afraid. But I stopped by to tell somebody how I raised the Hedges. The Bible says, if God be for you, who can be against you? Remember, Wilfong, you said something about the five rocks. Well, you done used one. Why did he have the other four? He had four more brothers. Just as big, 9 foot tall, 6 inch, 6 foot wide. He had four more brothers. He was going to get them too. Let me tell you something, brother and sister. Don't ever think you too bad that God can't use you. Don't think you done messed up so much in life that God can't use you. The devil is a liar. I got to thinking about David. David, what you trying to say to us? This is for the family, for everybody. The Bible says in 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6, listen what happened. David had an accident. Him and the man went out to fight, and they come back. The enemy done came in and tore up the camp and done stole all the children and everything that David had. Done took everything. And listen what David said. David was greatly distressed. The people spoke of stoning him because the soul of all the people was grieved, every man for his son and for his daughter. But the Bible said David encouraged himself and the Lord his God. See, when you know who God is, even though you're going through a storm that you're going through, you know that my eye will look toward the hill from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord which made heaven and the earth. I know you're sad right now. Now I know you're hurting right now. Because that night, 3 o'clock in the morning, on a Sunday morning, a.m., and I thought it was my daughter. Me and my wife was asleep in the bed. And I thought my daughter was trying to be funny, blowing her horn and flashing the lights. And I said, why is she doing that? So what I done, I went to the door. I said, ain't nobody but my daughter. I unlocked the door. I'm going back to bed because I thought she was trying to be funny. And see, I'm a preacher. I don't cuss. You'll catch it on your way home. I didn't cuss. I didn't. But it was David and his daughter that was upset. Because I thought maybe something done happened to one of my kids. I thought, oh Lord, that's something done happened. She's trying to be funny. When I heard them crying, I said, something wrong. Oh my God. When David said the word that he said to me, he said, he's gone. What words could I say to him? And that time when he was going through, I didn't have words to say to him. Only thing I could say, I'm here. I'm here if you need me.
Amen.
Then all the friends, and somebody got up and spoke, they were there at the scene, 3:30 in the morning. Crying. And I come by to tell somebody, let's get this thing right. I know you're young and you want to have fun. And can I be honest with you? When I was young, I party too. I did. Don't raise your hand. I mean, I did. I party and I drunk and I done some stupid stuff. I did. Don't think because I'm in a robe and I'm preaching that I had an easy life. No. But an older man now that I can help somebody else not go down the same road that we went down through. It's your life. It's how you treat yourself. When I wake up in the morning, I look in the mirror, I tell myself I look good. Y'all didn't hear nothing I just said. Sometimes you got to encourage yourself. All my life they said I'll never mount and I'll never be nothing. But I look in the mirror, boy, you look good. You're a fine looking man. And I said, yeah, I knew it. But I had to encourage myself. I always tell people, and David knows this, I'm always saying this, it ain't what they call you. It's what you answer to. The Lord is my shepherd. David understood who the Lord was. That's why he could pen this in this book. Because he goes on to say, listen, and then I'm going to get out of your way. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Brother David, Minister David, you hit it dead on the head. Matter of fact, let me just read it to the people in case they say, well, I ain't never read that. Let me get it for you. Philippians 4:19. Listen what it said. Okay, in 13, let's go 13 in 19. I can do all things. Got an S on it. Through Christ, we're strengthening me. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthened me. And then it goes on to say, Paul wrote, said, but my God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. I say to you, don't you give up on your dreams. I've been watching you and your brother for a long time. You're out there playing ball. You're trying to make something of your life. Don't let this be a setback. Make it be a comeback. Because you're going to do good. Yeah, you have done good, and I'm so proud of you. I ain't got no hat, but I take my hat off to you. Don't you give up your dream. Lump won't want you to do that. He wants you to go finish school and keep hitting them threes. You keep hitting them threes. And I say, David, his mama, you done good with these kids. You let them playing basketball and he had them everything. I said, David, you need to come to church. So I got to go here, Reverend Wilfong, with my kids. I said, I understand. But you done it, David. Don't ever think that you done something wrong. You didn't do nothing wrong. You done it. You just sit up and say what you had to say. And that made my heart feel good. Because I know you hurt. And I know she hurt. That night she came to my house, she was hurting. She was hurting, y'all. She was hurting. To see you sit here now and not crying and all that. I know you've been crying. But God's got something special for you. Amen. And like I said, Jeremiah 29 verse 11, you probably know what it is. And some of you don't know, you need to go read it. Young people. And I take my hat off to y'all both. Y'all done good with them kids. They know the way. Y'all showed them the way. Don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry. Be happy. God got y'all. God got you. You know that. He's my minister here for the youth. He's the minister here. And I've been working on his wife. And she knows there's an open door for her anytime she gets ready. Because I thought you were going to preach right here just now. But I want you to be encouraged and hang in there. I'm a close, y'all. Don't worry. Do 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 do. Be happy. Do 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 do. And I shall not want. He's making me to lie down in green pasture. He leadeth me beside the still water. He restoreth my soul and leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Here it is, here it is, here it is, here it is. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why, David? For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou prepared a table before the presence of my enemy. Thou anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will, and I will, and I will, and I will, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Family, be encouraged. Be like David. When he lost everything, he went into the house of the Lord and began to worship. I don't know what he done or how he done it. It could have been a song. He could have said, "Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. When we been there 10,000 years, by shining at the sun. We know last day to sing God's praise than when we first begun." They sing this language all over the world. They know this language all over the world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
I think we can do a little bit better than that. Can we give God another hand clap of praise for the word? At this time, before we proceed with our recessional, we would have you be reminded, those gentlemen that have been asked to serve as pallbearers, if you would, when I motion for you, meet us in the vestibule area at that time. Also, the ladies, as indicated on the back of the program, or if you've been asked to serve as a floral bearer, if when I motion for you, would come forward at that time to assist with the floral arrangements. Once we have put our dearly departed brother into the hearse, we do ask you would meet us in the middle of the parking lot for a special final tribute in honor of Brother Lump. And at this time, to you, the family, we, the staff of McCain Funeral Home and Cremations, consider it a privilege and an honor that you've entrusted us to serve you during this most difficult time. We certainly hope and pray everything has been found worthy of your satisfaction. As a token of our appreciation, receive this gift of love in honor of Brother Lump.
Thank y'all. Thank you. Thank you. Y'all pray for the family. It's only for the immediate family. Everybody cannot come up. Just for immediate family. Thank you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Father, we gather in this solemn place to remember the life and mourn the death of our beloved brother. We ask that you comfort each family member and friends. May they turn to your word for comfort, being carried through happy memories and purpose in their heart to seek you while you may be found. Amen. We'll be feeding the family immediately after service in the next room over. So if you want to stay and support the family, but let the immediate family go first before you go in there to eat. I think we got enough food for everybody in here, but let the immediate family go first.
So